back to our channel.
Today we're going to continue on with tearing out the rest of these walls and then putting up some new Luan paneling. We got about 4 sheets, so we'll see how far we can get with that. First, we got to clean up the mess that this lady right here made last.
As you can probably hear, it's raining right now. I mean, that really doesn't affect us very much, but it'll probably be loud if we're recording.
So this is the current state of the RV right now. And then we gotta clean all this up. We bought some paneling to try out to test on this back wall to see how it's gonna look. Hopefully it turns out okay.
We also got some more 2x4 so we can finish the floors and the bathroom. So hopefully we get to that today. We're definitely gonna get it to it sometime this weekend. And then besides the slide out floor, all the floors will be complete. So that's exciting.
Broke out our handy dandy little shop vac, cleaned it out and vacuumed all the crevices and whatnot. I got the fan drying out this wall. Hopefully by tomorrow we'll be able to put up our paneling. This wall's pretty much dry. There's nothing holding this window in. No framing, no nothing. All right, so now I am getting the walls ready to be put up, taking my measurements. We're gonna start out with this wall. We've got our basic measurements taken. That's this wall right here. I'm taking my measurements from each side, and that'll give me my angle at the top, and then the width right there. Same thing on the other side, and then the back wall. I'm trying to get this side done today, and then that side, and then just the top portion of this, because we're still trying to dry out the bottom here. We just finished peeling off the rest of it, and I threw some damper in here. And then maybe if we got time, we'll do this one as well. And then that's it for interior walls, other than the bottom portion of the slide. So we're trying to get all that done just to make it look a little better, make it look a little more finished. I'm gonna show you how I'm cutting this stuff and show you what exactly we're using. All right, so here we have our Luan paneling. It's 1/8 of an inch thick, redneck sawhorse. See if we can get a good angle somewhere. Now you can see I have all my lines, measurements cut out. That way I only have to do cut it all at the same time, and hopefully it turns out the right way. Alright, now we're gonna go test it. Alright, so for the most part it does fit. I'm just gonna have to trim around the edge a little bit, and then we'll come back and make our stencils to cut out the window. So far, so good. Looking better already. All right, so bright idea. Take the window out. Then take your sheet, put it up against there. Have somebody hold the other side. And while you're on the other side, draw out the stencil of the window itself. Take it off, cut it out, put it back, put the window back, you're done. And you don't have to worry about it. Sounds like a great idea. We're gonna try that. For the bottom, instead of trying to drill a hole that size in the corner, I'm just gonna cut a slot about the size of the cord and just slide it over top. This is stationary, so it's not really gonna matter if that cord fits inside. That's gonna be covered by a decorative box anyways. So let's go ahead and give that a shot. All right, so I got it up against, held up with a chair. You come outside and you take the point of your, if you got a fine point Sharpie, it'd be better, but this is all I had. And I just put it in as far in as possible. That way it's not even with this, because if it's even with this, your window inside trim's not gonna fit. Trace that along. I don't have a jigsaw at the moment, so we're gonna do the best that we can with a circular saw, and then I'll use a sawzall with a smaller blade, try to make those turns. I'm usually fairly good at that kind of stuff. We'll go ahead and just give that a shot. So I've decided it'll probably be best to attach it to the wall, go on the other side, and cut from that side with a sawzall. That way we get a better shape. And if I need to trim off any more, then I can do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. All right, so I'm using these trim screws by Pro Finish. They're 1 5/8 since we have the aluminum walls, and they got a smaller head on them so that they're easy to just put some wood filler over it so we can paint it, but it should work. If it comes with the free square bit, that's probably why they're so expensive, because it's $10 a box. For the most part, those trim screws work. They do protrude a little bit, but we're gonna put trim over it anyways. And as far as going next to the slide, I'm gonna have to try something different. That's a different type of aluminum, I guess. This is a little bit thicker. And as soon as the screw gets to a certain point, it just pops right through. So I'll try to get something with a thread that goes all the way up to the head for that. But I'm gonna go ahead and start cutting out the window now. That way we can get that put in, and that'll hold the wall in even better. So I've got my handy dandy sawzall, and then I've got the Ryobi's Job Max type cutting tool for around the corners. So we'll give that a shot. Cut, but the window should cover. Just
what's up?
No, get. I guess I should have thought this through. If I let go of this window, it's gonna fall. Need some tape.
Looks pretty good, doesn't it?
All right, so I'm gonna try doing this the wrong way. Go away.
Hi.
As I said, so just go away. Don't come in. Yeah, just go. Just for a few minutes. I didn't want her to see, because right now you can tell how badly it is, but once that window's in, it's gonna look perfect.
That looks really good.
I'm glad we're putting trimmer on it now, because
that looks so good.
Looks a lot better now, doesn't it? All right, so as you can see, wall number one is done for the most part. Looks good, except for this little gap. I went a little crazy with the sawzall, but we're gonna put like a 1x4 trim around it anyways, make it more homey, so that's fine. Pretty straight cut too, all the way down to the bottom. Still need to screw this in, but it's good. Next, tackle that side. I was using that as a spot to hold the tripod, but I don't know how I'm gonna be able to do it now. I guess I could just latch it onto the window, but let's get to it. All right, so we gotta take a little bit of a break. We're going to a Christmas parade downtown. We'll get a few shots of that for you. But other than that, we'll be back, and then we're gonna continue on this. I wanna get all these walls put up by tonight. All right, stay tuned. That's a little better. What, zoom in? So it's the next day, about 10:30 in the morning. Late start, but it's Sunday, so it's allowed. And this is what we got so far. I've got it cut out. I gotta trim down the bottom a little bit, because for some reason that side of the floor pitches up a little bit, but I'm not too worried about that since a couch is gonna go right here. Another issue, which isn't really an issue because we're gonna be ripping off this paneling anyways. This is what happens when you don't take care of your stuff or if you don't have the ability. It's just delaminated. I mean, you can see the other side. For now, it's exterior, technically. We're just gonna cut this piece, put the window back. Once we're done with most of the interior, we're gonna go with that nice hardy board stuff, kinda like that's on the side of that shed right there. See if we can get a better view of that. It's just wood paneling. It looks really nice when you trim it out, but I think it'll look good on here. So I'm gonna trim this up and attach it and then screw it back to the wall and install our window. Gotta get our redneck sawhorses back up. Always use a good blade on something like this. If not, it's gonna chew it up. I'm using the cordless. I got a corded Diablo blade over there. I'm gonna start using that instead. All right, so I got our window holding up our panel. We're gonna go ahead and attach the panel to the wall and do the same thing on this side that we did on the other side. But yeah, coming right along. All right, so believe it or not, the drywall screws worked out a lot better. So I'm gonna continue using them. Hopefully they last. I'm not sure why they wouldn't, but better than those trim screws that I got. I guess they're only good for trim. I'm gonna go to the other side. I'm gonna try to slowly cut out this one and make it look a little bit nicer and neater. Not that it matters, because we're gonna put trim over it anyways. Just want it to look good for now. All right, so now I'm gonna try putting the window back in again by myself, like I did the first one. All right, so now we got both sides up, looking pretty good. Throwing that window back in place really does make that wall a lot stronger. It is upsetting that the only thing holding those windows in is the paneling and the outside siding. But once we get that hardy board on the outside, I think it'll be way stronger even then, because all we are really screwing to is that delaminated mess there. So I'm gonna move on to this wall, the top portion. I'm gonna try to get this window out myself and hopefully don't mess anything up. This window does have supports right here and on the other side as well, so that makes it better. But on this side, there's nowhere to screw to except for the top and the bottom. But we'll make it look all pretty. The bottom's still drying out. I turned the power off last night so that we're still a little sketchy leaving the power on at night. But hopefully that'll be all dried out by the end of today and I'll be able to put on our pieces then. So one sheet should come down to about right here if I measured it correctly. And it's not a full 8 foot. I think it's 7 foot 7 from interior wall to interior wall. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that taken care of. Get a piece cut and put up. Moving along nicely. I think I'm gonna set y'all up on top of the refrigerator here. What are you doing, Chips? What are you doing? What are you running from? Who do you owe money to? All right, so I've got all the interior trim taken off, taken out every single little screw, and then you also need to take off the little round thing, the little window knob. It does not want to focus on this thing. We're most likely gonna have to replace these because I cracked one of them. Because it didn't want to come off. Yeah, but you get the idea. Take those off and then take your outer trim off and then you should be able to just push your window out. Most likely has some sealant around it, but when you put it back, just make sure you put caulking around the interior edge on the other side of this. Back to the fridge you go. Measurements here for the bottom or for the top, but just to be sure, because I've had to cut twice on every piece so far, I'm gonna measure one more time just to make sure. It says 92 7/8. I'm gonna go with 92 1/4 this time. All right, we got it all cut and ready to fit in. Measured twice, so hopefully I don't have to cut twice. Looks like it's gonna fit. How'd you get out, huh? How'd you get out? Chip saw his girlfriend today, Maggie. We were wondering why we haven't seen her for the past couple days. And she comes back with a broken leg and stitches. So we had to return her back home. All right, so we got our first piece up. I'm just trying to get that bottom to dry out a little more before I put this on. I don't want to be working backwards. I want it to last for the most part. So I'm gonna let that continue drying and I'm just gonna go ahead and start cutting out the top portion of the window. So yeah, moving right along. All right, so I'm checking the test fitment of the window trim. Everything seems to be working good. Now, for this bottom part, like I said, I'm letting it dry out. I've got enough of the scrap pieces. If I do one in the corner, one in this corner, and then use the piece that I cut out right here, down here at the bottom, that'll be fine because this should be covered up with a couch, and we're building a box down there for all the electrical to hide. So I'm not too worried about that. And then I can use my last sheet that I bought to finish up right here and be completely done replacing any Luan that's gonna be done in here. All this is fine. Everything in there is good. The bathroom is exceptional as far as the walls go. That's pretty good. All that's good. The bedroom, all I gotta do is build a support up in there and then we can screw that back down. There is a piece in the closet that I'm gonna have to replace, but that's coming out anyways. And then these walls are good. It'll all be good. This will be one of our next videos. We're gonna be tearing all this out, finishing up this room, getting it done and taken care of. And then we're gonna do the same concept where we have a flip up bed, but it's just gonna be new wood basically, and possibly a little taller. But that's what we got so far. It's getting so excited. It's starting to look done. We have a lot of work to do, but we don't have a lot of work to do inside. But we're plugging away at it. We'll get it done and taken care of.
All right, so while I'm letting the other side dry, I'm gonna go ahead and get this all taken care of. I've gotta remove the window and that vent is gonna be obsolete. No more, we don't need it. And then I'm gonna trim, I don't know if you can see in the camera, but I drew a line. It's my 4 foot mark for my piece. That way I can get my measurement to cut it properly. So yeah, I'm gonna get to that, tear out the window, clean it all up, get it all ready so I can just cut it and put it on the wall. Not really anywhere to screw from except for the door itself, ceiling part, so we'll figure something out.
All right, so we got this wall up. I'm gonna go ahead and measure out and cut and make my cuts for that part. And hopefully by that time, that bottom section will be dried out so we can finish that as well.
Hey guys, so I haven't really been in this video very much because I have been sitting down editing this video so it goes up today. It's already, let's see, 3:16 usually. See, so this is what I've been doing today, all of this. So, as you're seeing this video should be up in a little bit because I've been sitting here editing it. It's gonna be a long one because we have a lot more footage than we usually do, which is good. But also it's gonna take a little bit longer to finish because it is a longer video. Like Brandon's been filming a lot and doing a lot. So the battery died earlier when he was filming, so it's been charging. We need to get some more batteries. Now let's go ahead and go check on him and see where he's at, like within the RV, so. Hello. Hey, Bannon.
All right, so all the walls are now in. I've got my cables ran up just to try to clean it or get it to look a little cleaner. Now you show up.
Shut up!
I'm just kidding. All the Luan is in. What do you think?
Wait! I think you did a very good job. I'm very proud of you.
Thank you. Alright, so that's all we got for you this week. We hope that you enjoyed. If you liked it, like it, comment, subscribe, hit the bell notification so you'll never miss another video from us again. And they'll just keep on getting better and better.
Thank you guys for all your support so far. I hope that you watched the entire video and you had fun. If you haven't seen the rest of our videos, there's always a playlist link down below with the video starting from 1 to this current video, which is part 8. We will see you guys in our next video. Bye.